All right, so today we try something different. I promised you guys I'll take a look at the fixed wing mode, and today we are outside, so I'm going to film the screen of my iPhone so that you can see what the Mavic gives me on input when it's able to go into fixed wing mode and when not. And I'm also going to sync it up with the actual footage of the Mavic. So, wish me luck.
But first, let's activate the fixed wing mode. For this, go to your settings, go to your controller, and make sure that you toggle the switch for the fixed wing mode.
Take off. The home port has been updated. Please check it on the map.
Now I'm going to show you how to use the fixed wing mode. I'd recommend to try the mode in a wide open area, cause when the Mavic is entering the fixed wing mode, it continuously moves forward. First thing you need to do is to reach a horizontal speed of about 10 km per hour. By doing so, the controller symbol on the left changes into an airplane and prompts you to press the C1 button. In case you were wondering, you can find it on the bottom left side of your controller. Once you hit the C1 button, the Mavic enters the fixed wing mode and tells you how fast it is going to go. To cancel the continuous movement, just hit the C2 button. Now let me give you an example how the movement of the Mavic is affecting the footage. Mavic now completely behaves like an airplane. The gimbal makes it look like you're leaning into the corner. And if you want to go up or down, the camera even tilts up or down while you're doing so. And as you can see here, the Mavic isn't really able to take sharp corners, so keep that in mind. In case you were wondering about the perfect reflections on the water, the Mavic normally isn't able to achieve this kind of reflections by itself, so I'm using CP filters on the Mavic to achieve this perfect look. In case you don't know what they are, I linked them up top so you can check out another video I did about CP filters and ND filters, and especially at the end of this footage you see how well they perform under these lighting conditions.
So what do you guys think about the new feature? Is it worth it? Would you use it? What do you think? Tell me in the comments. So I definitely will use the new feature because I really like the look and feel of it, and it's so much fun to fly around like this, but always keep in mind to rest your finger on the C2 button, because in case that you have to brake immediately or something. So tell me in the comments below which features I should check out next, and if you have any ideas, stop by and tell me about them. And as always, thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe. See you guys next time.